Previously on The Bill.
Joanna is now categorised high risk. We inform the press of Joanna's identity and we tell them who her mother is.
He shouldn't have found out Luke was gay.
What do you mean he's gay?
If somebody out there has got my baby, please let her go.
Broad daylight, you couldn't make that up, could you?
Yeah, it doesn't look very good. The commissioner's doing his nut, apparently.
Who cares about how it looks? All that matters is finding Eva's little girl.
Yeah, I met Joanna at the open day. Nice kid. What was that?
It's over there, I think. Can you hear me?
Oh.
It's not her. I think you better call for an ambulance.
Sierra Oscar from 362.
Who's done this to you, mate?
Can we have an ambulance, please?
No one. I fell.
Uniform coordinating a physical search. They'll have backup from Barton Street and Stafford Road. Community safety are on top of the known sexual offenders' inquiries. We will extend the interviews with the persistent sex offenders geographically as we extend the physical search.
You've been in touch with the National Crime Faculty?
Yes, support officers on his way.
And what about response to the appeal? Are we geared up?
Well, only four lines at the moment, Gov.
It's not enough.
Well, I know. I was hoping the super was going to sort that out.
Press?
Yeah, snapping at our heels, going mental. I'd like to opt for hourly briefings, whether we have something to tell them or not. Keep them at the station and hopefully out of our hair.
What about Eva?
She's at home, Gov. With Jim Carver?
Yeah, Paul's out searching with his brothers, and I've told him and the rest of the family that they're to call me on Paul's mobile. I've told Samantha that she's to call me on my mobile, and that would leave the home phone for Joanna to call.
Okay.
I know it's not ideal, the landline, but it's the number that I've told Joanna to use if she ever gets into trouble. If we're out, my mum's usually here, or one of Paul's lot. So.
Sounds like a close family.
The implication being... Sorry. Have they interviewed any of Joanna's friends yet?
You know they have.
The whole list?
The whole list.
I'm sorry, Jim. I can't think.
I'm not surprised. Excuse me a minute.
Mom.
Jim.
All this activity, it's not helping. Is there any need for all these people to be here?
Well, I've only just arrived. I'll see what Craig's got to say for himself.
Yes, Mum?
Jim reckons that Eva needs a bit of peace and quiet.
Okay, well, we've done all we can here. So.
Oh, good. I'll get them to shift their arses.
Waiting for confirmation of it.
You all right, Craig?
Yeah, I'm fine.
His name's Robin Parks. He said he was running and fell over.
Oh, that's not what the paramedics reckon.
No, he's had a good kicking. Question is, why is he lying?
Look, I think one of us should go down the hospital with him.
Well, what about the search?
No, I don't want to sit around casualty all night.
Come on, lads, it's an assault.
All right, we'll toss for it. Loser gets to go to the hospital.
Heads.
Right, I'll leave you to it then.
You might as well get off and all, Jim.
Well, I'm not going anywhere. I'm your family liaison officer.
I'm a copper. I don't want family liaison.
We have a duty of care to a mother whose daughter's missing, whether you're a copper or not.
Oh, please. Bull. I know the drill, remember? Get close, win the family's trust, keep your eyes open, gather intelligence. You're here to pry.
Yeah, too right I am.
And what good's that gonna do? Listen. I have told Samantha everything you need to know. I have handed over everything and anything that might conceivably be relevant to the inquiry. Personal stuff of Joanna's. So please, if you do not mind, I would prefer if you were out there looking for my daughter.
They said you found my husband.
Yeah.
Was he beaten up?
Well, the medic seems to think so, but he says not.
Well, Robin wouldn't lie.
Can you think of anyone that would hold a grudge against your husband?
Only anyone of a number of ex-cons. Robin's a prison officer at Walworth Jail.
Has he ever had any trouble before?
Well, never. He's been doing the job for 20 years.
Yeah, I suppose it could be a simple robbery. Did Mr. Parks have anything on him that was worth stealing?
His wallet, his keys.
No, he's got his wallet and keys. Anything else?
His beige jacket and his sports bag. I remember putting his sandwiches into it.
No sign of any bag.
Well, who'd want to steal Robin's sports gear?
Yeah, who indeed?
Years ago, I was family liaison when a teenage girl went missing. It was only the second or third time I'd done it. And we went through the usual procedures. We questioned the family and we checked all our usual haunts. And the fuss died down, as it always does. And eventually it was just me and the mother sitting in the house drinking tea. We were talking about what the girl was going to do for her GCSEs. And the mother mentioned, by the by, that the girl loved animals, particularly birds.
So you found her?
In Epping Forest. She'd fallen out of a tree.
And she was all right?
Cuts and bruises. Dented pride.
You mentioned something about drinking tea and gasping.
Milk and sugar?
Yep.
Edward Barker, 4 years for gross indecency with a little girl.
We should be looking for that kid. Not out talking to nonces.
But this is important, Des. Uniform aren't going to stumble across her if she's in a locked room. Doesn't bear thinking about. Look, I know these people are disgusting perverts, but one of them might know where Joanna is or who's got her. I think you're forgetting. Eva's a very good friend of mine.
Stupid bloody care. Can't even look after her own kids. And she calls herself a police officer.
Don't be daft.
Do you think that Samantha planted those questions with the journalists? Try and trip us up?
Oh, come on, you know that's not true.
No, it's not. It's what we do, isn't it? The police. Rule nothing out. Refuse to make assumptions. Paul and I are in the frame for it, and that's right, he knows. It's only fit and proper. Until Joanna's found. Alive or dead.
Your wife says you had your sports bag with you.
No, I don't think so.
She said she put your sandwiches in it.
Vivian can be very forgetful.
Well, with all due respect, Mr. Parks, you seem to be the one who has trouble remembering. See, I think you were beaten up. And the doctor agrees with me. I also think you had your bag stolen. But what I don't understand is why you're lying.
If I refuse to make a complaint, you'll have to drop this, right? I refuse to make a complaint. Happy now?
Yeah, ecstatic.
I was tense, stressed out. I'd promised Paul that I'd be free, and when he arrived with the kids, I was up to my neck in a case. And I knew Paul was angry with me, so I took it out on Joanna.
Well, you mustn't know this turns to self-recrimination, Eva.
Yeah. Hard to avoid, though. Seeing as how it's my fault she ran away.
Well, to be honest, Mum, I'm glad he won't make a complaint. I'd rather be out there looking for Joanna.
Good. Go and file a report and then find Sergeant Gilmore, because he's in charge, right?
Mum. Hey,
you all right?
I've been looking for you.
Why?
Are you having an affair with a man?
I beg your pardon?
It's a simple question.
Yeah, and it's a simple answer. Yet again, no.
Okay. Was some guy called Joe all over you outside the station?
Kerry, he was a witness in a case.
Just answer the question, Luke.
He came on to me. I wasn't going to tell you.
Because you fancy him?
Oh, I've had enough of this. Snide insinuations. What is it that makes everyone think I'm some sort of queer, eh? I am your husband. I'm a police officer. And I'm gonna be a dad. Isn't that enough proof for you?
I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry. Just get all this crap out your head.
I hate talking to nonsense.
Hey, what are they up to?
Who cares?
Hey, lads, can I have a word? Hey!
Come back, you little maggots!
Luke and I talked about it, and he put my mind at rest. I can see what people might think it. He's good-looking, he's well turned out, he's sensitive. But I know Luke is 100% hetero. I am carrying his baby, after all.
Sorry.
No, don't be. But I tell you what, though, Sarge, you want to get your gaydar fixed. It's seriously rusty.
You've got nowhere left to run, mate. And what did you run away for in the first place?
I didn't know you was a copper.
Who dumped this?
It's not mine.
So you stole it?
No, I found it.
Have we got time for this?
Won't take a minute. And what's this then, eh?
Looks like heroin to me.
No way. That's not mine.
I joined that party there.
Sarge, we've finished in that area.
Anything?
No, nothing. What next?
Just give me one second.
Sarge, where do you want me to start?
Luke, I'd like a word with you in private.
I'd rather carry on with the search.
I saw you and Joe earlier, just before Kerry did. Seems like you had a close call.
We were just talking.
So, where would you like my team to start looking then, Sarge? Tennis courts?
No, we've done those. I'd like you to take the area between the trees and the road.
Sarge.
Sarge.
What?
We haven't searched the tennis courts yet.
Haven't we?
No.
So we haven't. How could I...
Look, you're tired. We all are.
What if Joanna's there?
Look, I'll go and search the tennis courts. Don't worry. Secret's safe for me.
You take Mrs. Dalton and get yourself upstairs, and Nana will read your bedtime story.
Good night, Mum.
Good night. Funny, isn't it? This is the moment where you would say, oh, what a great kid. Or, oh, takes after his mum, doesn't he? But you can't. Because it just reminds us that the other one isn't here.
Oh, Craig! Oi! Craig! Craig! What's the matter?
I was about to sign off on an area that hadn't been searched.
Well, that's not so bad, as long as you caught the mistake.
I didn't. Gemma spotted it.
Still, there's no harm done.
It's gone too far.
What has?
I'm sorry, Gina, I can't do this anymore.
I expect you'd like to talk about the state of our marriage next.
Yeah.
Or perhaps you'd like to talk about the strategies I've put in place to protect my children if they ever get into trouble. I mean, I am a police officer after all. And as you'd expect, I take the personal safety of my children very seriously.
That's up to you.
Right. Let's talk about what I told Joanna to do if she ever gets into trouble. I think that's potentially more fertile, seeing as how I know my marriage is fine.
Okay.
Right. Well, obviously, I have drilled it into Joanna that she is never to talk to strangers. Mind you, I also taught her not to steal. And that's exactly what I caught her doing.
How's it going with the sex offenders?
I'm sure I ain't talking about me.
Just shut it, Jenny.
We've got a bit distracted.
So I see.
We'll check him in as quick as we can, then we'll be back out there.
We'll make sure you do.
We're almost three quarters of the way through the list, and to be honest, it's not looking promising.
Oh. Gov.
Well, we've answered over 200 calls so far. Mickey Webb's drowning, so I thought that you and I could help him in prioritising leads.
Of course, Gov. I just needed to clear my head.
I suppose you were thinking about Eva, eh?
How did you know that?
Well, Martin might be growing up, but he never stopped being a parent.
No.
Paul slept with someone else once. Work Christmas party. Felt so guilty about it, he owned up to it.
What did you do?
Decided to pay him back in kind. Not that I ever got round to it. We rowed a lot. I smashed things. So what you're saying now is this the reason why Joanna went missing? She's naughty. A naughty little girl, that's what everyone says. Takes after her mother, they say. Samantha Nixon's daughter disappeared to punish her mother. What, do you think that's what Joanna's done? Oh. I see. Let me speak now. Hoping that I'll spill that precious detail, that particular nugget. Well, I'm sorry, Jim. I was right in the first place. You're wasting your time. I haven't got a clue where Joanna is or why she's gone. All I know is that she wandered out of the police station where I work, and anyone could have her, could be doing anything to her. I want to help you, but I can't.
I thought I could hack it. Be the sergeant who happens to be gay rather than the gay sergeant. But a straight bloke would never have behaved like this over a girl.
So what's the real problem? Luke? Or being a gay police officer?
I'm now showing Ollie exhibit CB2. Is this the sports bag you claim you found?
You know it is. This is a waste of time.
I'm now showing exhibit CB3. This is the sports kit we found in the bag. Do you recognise any of it?
It was in the bag. I had a quick shufty before you two got on my case. You should be out looking for that kid.
I'm now showing exhibit CB4. Several plastic bags containing brown powder found secreted within the bag.
I told you, man, that ain't mine. You ain't doing me for no brown.
Brown? He knows a lingo.
I might know where that kid is.
Do I look like I've just jumped off a spaceship from the planet Zoot?
There's no need for all this. Dad's gonna have a word.
Interview suspended, 21:13.
Never been entirely comfortable.
Not just in the police. You never struck me as the type to dress up in drag and go shopping.
No.
A real man's man, in the true sense of the word. Let me guess. I bet you played rugby.
Second row.
There you go. So, strapping South Wales lad discovers he fancies other lads. And decides that doesn't make him a fairy, sets out to prove it.
Yeah, that just about sums it up, actually.
But you didn't join the police force to deny your sexuality.
Of course not.
And if God chose you to be a copper, he also made you homosexual. That's a tough combination. Very tough. And I don't reckon he expects you to cope all on your own.
What's the alternative?
Well, there are support groups, organisations. The Lesbian and Gay Police Association. Have you actually ever been to one of their meetings?
No.
Then don't prejudge them. I know a couple of bloody good coppers who are very active in LAGPA.
I can't believe we're having this conversation and Eva's child is missing.
In an emergency, we end up taking a very long, hard look at ourselves.
Oh, I'm being selfish.
You've been out searching all day and half the night. Doesn't sound selfish to me. Come on, back to work. There are Luke Ashtons everywhere, in every walk of life. And I think you need to sort out what the real problem is before you make any rash decisions. All right, come on.
And until we discover anything to the contrary, we remain resolutely optimistic we will find Joanna alive and well.
Well, I'd just like to reiterate that all the resources of the Metropolitan Police have been mobilised to ensure that this inquiry comes to a speedy and positive conclusion.
Thank you all.
We better find some news before they start making it up.
You're lucky we're letting you go.
And drugs weren't mine.
So you say.
This is a miscarriage of justice.
Yeah, well, take it up with the House of Lords.
I saw that kid.
Do you want?
What's his problem?
Claims he found a bag that just happens to be chocker full of heroin.
Where?
Down by the canal.
What sort of bag? Well, it exactly fits the description his wife gave.
So some screw got beaten up, had his bag nicked, and then denied the whole thing ever happened.
Yeah, it's hardly surprising since he was carrying heroin into prison. It's one for CID, that.
So could I leave it with you? I've got to get back to Kathy Bradford and the local paedophile register.
Hello, can I help you? I've been speaking to this young man, and he tells me one of your officers ignored his tip-off about the missing girl.
PC Taverner, bald skasket.
I'm sure he wouldn't ignore an important piece of information.
Well, we did.
We want to speak to the officer in charge of the investigation into the disappearance of Joanna Sharp.
No, you did right.
Listen, I know you've got other things on your mind.
No, this is serious stuff. A prison officer currying drugs, if that's what's going on. Mickey, this bright young PC is about to fill you in on a set of very interesting circumstances. Thank you, Luke.
Tell you what, that sounds well dodgy.
So what do you reckon? Head back to the hospital and interview him again?
Nah. So you go down the hospital, yeah? Come in. Make sure his parks don't do a runner. What about his missus? Do you reckon she's in on it?
No, I'm pretty sure she's not.
Don't let Parks know we found the bag. Just play dumb if he starts asking questions.
Why?
Well, because I don't let him know we're onto him, that's why. Plus, it takes me time to organise a warrant.
You know, search his house?
Seems like a good place to start.
Earlier this evening, a black girl, about 7 or 8, playing on the rubbish near the railway line.
So why didn't you tell us before?
I tried to tell PC Taverner.
All right, I'll speak to PC Taverner about that later. Now, are you absolutely sure this is what you saw?
He said, didn't he?
I'm about to commit significant resources to checking this out. Resources that could be deployed on other avenues of inquiry.
I saw that girl, right?
So, did this Ollie boy tell you he had a lead on Joanna's disappearance?
It was a wind-up.
Yeah, they did.
Right.
I have to say, Gov, I agree with Des. If you pursue this, you'll be wasting your time. This is not what you imagine.
In what way?
A mother's worst nightmare, and all we can do is sit here and talk.
All right, it's only me.
Any news?
Not so far, no.
Right, so why are you back?
It's too dark. The police reckon we might do more harm than good.
We'll start again at first light, all right?
DC Webb from Sun Hill.
It's the middle of the night.
I've got a warrant to search his premises.
What for?
Drugs. Yeah.
Des Taverner thinks he's talking crap, and Kathy Bradford agrees.
So what's the journalist's involvement?
Sniffed a story. No more, no less.
So we've got a kid found in possession of heroin. He's got a clear and identifiable grudge against this station. Says he saw a girl matching Joanna's description. It's a wafer thin.
Understatement of the century. So what do we do?
Well, we've got to follow it up. The press are onto it. And if we're not seen to act, they'll just crucify us.
I'll make it happen.
Looking for drugs. My husband doesn't even drink.
You suspect Mr. Parks is a supplier, not a user.
A supplier? You've made a very serious mistake, and I'm going to make sure you pay for it.
Let's move upstairs, eh?
You keep out of my bedroom!
Yeah.
You know Jim Carver, don't you? He's acting as our family liaison officer.
Right.
Well, I'm here to keep you informed. Make sure you've got everything you need.
Yeah. It's Jim's job to keep us talking, thinking, exploring every possibility.
Like we aren't already. Look, how's Sammy?
Fast asleep. My mum's spark out in the chair next to him.
That's one bonus, then.
Your lot's come up with anything concrete, then?
Yes, Samantha will get back to us when they do. She promised.
Oh, what about the response to the appeal?
Oh, I'll call in again, see where they're up to.
Yeah. I'll get it.
Oh, hi.
Hi. Have you found her?
No, Eva. Not yet.
So what are you doing here, then?
You see? I told you you wouldn't find anything.
What's this?
Key.
Yeah, I know it's a key. What's it for?
I don't know.
What do you all mind keeping storage, then, eh?
Nothing that I know of. We'll make a search of the entire area bordering the railway line on one side and the canal on the other, between Rust Street to Brookvale Road. Sergeant Gilmore will stay here, mind the fort. Any questions? Yes. Well then, off you go.
It's a waste of time.
Oh, shut it, Tavner.
Why am I staying here? You think I'm not up to the job?
You're all over the place at the moment. You said so yourself.
We have sent a team out to follow a specific lead. A teenager who saw a girl who fits Joanna's description.
Where?
On the railway line by Bankside Private Hospital.
When?
About 2 hours ago.
That's something.
Yeah.
I just want to warn you, please don't get your hopes up. The teenager was arrested for possession, so it's possible the lead is a hoax, designed to waste police time.
So why are you taking it seriously, then?
Well, he was very specific, and he was adamant.
Did the press know? They do, don't they?
One journalist has got wind of it, yeah.
So this is why you're following it up?
What do you mean?
Excuse me. Samantha Nixon.
If the cops don't follow up a positive sighting, then the press could run a story saying that the police have been ignoring leads provided by the public.
Eva, I'm sure the DI wouldn't chase this up if she thought it was bogus.
No, it won't be, Joanna. Yeah. They're wasting their time.
Mummy, I can't sleep.
Mm-hmm. What's up, soldier?
Yes.
Hey? Fancy letting a journalist get so close.
I don't reckon they had much choice. She came in with the tip-off.
I think you'd be a bit more specific.
It was hours ago now, and it was getting dark.
Maybe PC Taverner should have taken Ollie more seriously.
You two wait here. I don't want you moving an inch. And if I catch you taking any photographs, I will personally smash that camera myself, okay? Brandon!
That's the first section complete, Mum. Nothing.
Maybe Des was right after all.
We're a long way from the police station.
Well, that's why we didn't search here last night.
Have you declared it a major incident yet?
No.
But you've set all the systems in place, yeah?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means they don't expect to find Joanna soon. Somebody's got her.
We're just getting prepared, that's all.
I can't bear this. Look, it's light now. Come on, bro, let's go.
Hey, what will you do?
I don't know. We'll go up the school and we'll just see if anybody remembers anything. You stay here and look after Sammy.
Look, Eva, I've got to go too. If I hear anything, I'll let you know.
Thanks.
Okay.
So, looks like it's just you and me again.
You don't know somebody's got her.
Don't I?
Cheers for coming early, mate.
I don't know if this is happening. We're two-thirds of the way along. Nothing.
Well, it's morning now. Well, I wonder where Joanna spent the night.
Mum! I think we found something.
He's down here, Mum!
What do you reckon? Dunno. Sounds a child could have spent the night here.
A little girl. Question is, if she was here, where is she now?
Any news on the search?
No, not so far.
What's with the laptop?
It belongs to Parks, a potentially dodgy prison officer. I found it in the self-storage unit that he rents.
No more drugs, then?
Nah, just the laptop, which our friend Kieran is trying to unlock.
Who knows what we might find?
I wouldn't hold your breath, to be honest, girl.
Are you sure she was playing near here?
Pretty sure.
Brandon!
What now?
Let the DI know. I reckon she's going to want to organise a search and do a house to house round here.
But we're not even sure that Joanna's been here. She wasn't carrying a doll when she left the station.
Unless she's been here before, you know, played here regularly.
No, but it's miles away from her home, her school, her friends.
There she is.
What?
That's a girl I saw.
Oh, that's not Joanna.
Whatever happened to knocking?
You won't believe what we just found on Parks' laptop. Sarge.
Mick.
I need a car or a lift. My motor's gone in for an MOT and all the pool cars are out.
Where are you going?
St. Hughes, to arrest a paedophile.
Give me a lift.
Thank you.
Oh, I see.
Well, it turns out this Ollie wasn't lying. He did see a girl, but it was not Joanna.
She must be gutted.
Yeah, well, we all are, Des. Wouldn't you prefer to find Joanna in that den alive and well?
I didn't mean that.
Been here hours.
It was worth the wait.
Why? Because Parks is a paedophile.
No.
He's found dodgy files on his computer. I reckon he's been blackmailed from the inside to courier drunks.
It's a good result, Luke.
Thanks, Sarge. Listen, do you mind if I nip to the little boys' room? Thanks. Oh, hang on. DCI, I better take
them. All right, mate. Do you mind? Hey, have you got any ID?
Yeah!
All right, put the weapon down!
Oh, my God!
Yeah. Yeah, I understand. Thanks for calling, girl. It's not Joanna. There was a girl, apparently. But it's not Joanna.
You all right?
Can you hear me?
Yeah. You'll be fine.
Kerry! What is it?
There's been an incident at St. Hughes. An officer's been injured.
Wait, is it Luke?
I don't know. You're coming with me.
Whoa. Some guys came to beat the crap out of Parks. Craig got in the way.
Are you going to be all right?
I don't know. Did you see anyone? They legged it. Got
uniform on the lookout. Security checking CCTV. Right. Where you go? I'm gonna rush that pervert Parks.
Sorry.
That clock is driving me up the wall. That's better. I can still hear it ticking. At last. Silence. Hello? No, I do not want to take part in your survey. Now get off the line now!
Eva.
Don't, Jim.
Poor Craig. He got a right beating.
It was you.
I got here too late.
I'm so glad you're all right.
So, broken ribs, messed up face, multiple bruising. I'd say you're a very lucky fellow.
Strange definition of lucky.
We'll be off for months. Chance to think.
No need. Decided I'm leaving.
Craig, what you did this morning proved everything that I've been saying. You put yourself in physical danger to defend a paedophile so the legal system can take care of him. You upheld the rule of law. You are a copper from the top of your head to the tip of your toes.
I didn't say I was leaving the police service. I'm going to transfer. When Luke saw that I was hurt, he got really upset.
So you can leave me all on my lonesome?
We can keep in touch.
Yeah, of course we can.
Off the internet.
Well, according to our IT expert, some of the images were downloaded, but most of them were scanned.
Which means you've got contacts. Which tells us you're part of a ring.
No comment.
Joanna's got PE today.
What would you be doing normally now?
I'll be getting a PE kit together. Can you believe that's Joanna?
Well, go on then.
Sorry?
Don't give up hope.
I can't.
Well, tell us where our stuff is then. I'll get it ready.
I'll promise you one thing. You're going to have a fantastic time in prison. The next prison officer on the Nazis wing.
Do you think I don't know that?
So do yourself a favour.
Tell us who else is in the ring. Give us some names, eh? We'll go much better for you in court.
I don't know what you're talking about. I've never even met another paedophile.
So what are you so scared of?
I thought you would.
Well, I'm not.
I'm glad.
I'm leaving Sunhill. That's what you wanted.
Not really. Not deep down. I'm scared. Carrie and the baby. I don't know what to do.
You gotta tell her the truth. She's having a baby. She deserves honesty.
I can't.
How do you think Eva Sharp's feeling right now? Whatever pain you're going through doesn't even begin to compare. You have to tell Gary.
Are you still in love with me? Is that why you want me to come out to Gary?
You're a liar. And I'm a liar. That's why I'm leaving. I want to start again. And the next time I meet a Luke Ashton, I'm going to be honest from the word go.
I'm sorry. Please don't leave because of me.
Tell her, Luke. For once in your life, be honest.
All right. Is that everything?
Yeah. Something won't be right, though. You know what Joanna's like.
Well, that's just it, Eva. I don't.
Oh, yes, you do, Jim. I've told you everything. The facts, figures, secrets, lies, bedroom confidences, scenes from a marriage. The home life of Paul and Eva Sharp and their two beautiful children. I've told you it all, everything. I have talked until my jaw aches. Until my head is pounding from the sound of my own voice. And where has it got us, eh? Nowhere. Absolutely bloody nowhere!
Come on.
No! No. I will not cry. What's going on between Luke and Craig?
Sorry?
Is my husband gay? Tell me.
I don't like it.
How do you mean?
Parks. He's taken the rap on his own. Makes me think the people he's involved with are particularly scary.
Not that we know they are.
No.
Mickey? What's the news on Parks?
We bagged ourselves a paedophile, Gov.
It's a nasty coincidence.
Isn't it just?
How's Eva doing?
Coping, not coping. It's hard to tell. Why can't we find her daughter?
That'll be the morning paper. Think Joanna will be on the front page?
If you told Gary the truth, maybe you and I could have some sort of future.
We've got to get something sorted out once and for all. You have to tell Kerry what really happened on Duke's stag night.
They're just vile, aren't they? The ones that the kids play normally, they're almost worse.
Yeah, I know what you mean, Gov. Normal, happy children. Then you think what's been done to them in their mother photos.
Some of these pictures, they've got to be 20 years old. So is it still going on?
Well, a few of them were taken with a digital camera, look there. Yeah.
This garden. Something familiar about it.
You reckon?
Nah. It's just me getting old and senile. So you're gonna get some sleep?
Not likely, Gov. I'm gonna help the DI follow up the leads we've got from the telephone response.
Anything promising?
Dunno, she's briefing now.
Tell her how you made a pass at Luke and he turned you down.
It's true. Luke was drunk and I tried to take advantage. I'm sorry, Kerry.
Why didn't you tell me?
I'm sorry. I knew how much you looked up to the Sarge. I didn't want to spoil that. And nothing happened. Yeah, that's right, nothing happened.
Well, I saw you holding hands before.
I was telling Luke how much I miss him. How much I miss all of you. I'm putting in for a transfer.
Well, I'll miss you too, Sarge.
Come on, Luke, let's get back to the search.
Yeah. Yeah. See you, Sarge.
See you. Why did you make me lie?
They're married. She's pregnant.
I reckon you just crossed the line. I'm glad I won't be around to see this blowing up in Kerry's face.
That's all for me.
Mickey! I do recognise this garden. Statue, trees. It's Howard Sinclair's garden.
The judge? The one who's taking all the bribes?
The very same. He's been blackmailed, I know he is. Somebody knows he's a paedophile. That's why he's been perverting the course of justice.
It makes sense, finally.
Do you know I recognise that garden? Because my kids have played there.
I tell you, Mickey, if he's touched...
Whoa, whoa, Gov.
You know what else this means? It's a paedophile ring. And it goes all the way to the top.
So, can we put all this business behind us now?
Of course. We're having a baby.
A prison officer and a judge, eh? Who else?
Yeah. Don't be thinking about. Gov.
What?
The timing.
What, you mean Eva Sharp's daughter goes missing and we turn up a nest of perverts?
Yeah. Do you reckon they're connected?
Well, for Joanna's sake, I sincerely hope not.
I've had enough of this. Talking. I can't sit in my end. I am not just a mother. I'm a copper too. And I'm going back to work.
Next time on The Bill.
We've moved the investigation to the incident room.
Are you okay? And what happened to your face?
I'm on bail. You're not allowed to do this.
Stop. You tell me what I'm allowed to do.
Joanna.